Hey guys! Welcome to another episode in the Geodesics Modules series. A new module has joined the Geodesics collection, Entropia, and oh boy, what a beauty! Let's start! Okay, so here it is, Entropia, a thermodynamic microstate sequencer. Let's start first with an overview of what we are dealing with, and then build a patch from scratch, utilizing all of Entropia's different features. So Entropia is an 8-step sequencer, but it has a nice twist to it. It's actually built out of two 8-step sequencers, a blue one, the inner circle, and a yellow one, the outer circle, and they interact in different ways and create a unique sequence, which we will get from the main output in the center of the module. Now, by turning the knobs, we can set different values for each step, and we have a few different options for both sequencers. First of all, we can choose if the values will be quantized to a musical interval by turning on the Planck constant function, which is on by default, and we can also change the range of the values by changing the energy settings. Let's send the main output to the voltmeter, and also to the tuner, so we can see the different values. Right now we have 3 lights on, which means that each knob will have a range of 3 octaves, starting from C3. If we click it once, we will have a range of 5 octaves, starting from C2. And if we click it 2 more times, we will have a range of 1 octave, starting from C4. Now, when the Planck constant function is turned off, the values are no longer quantized, and the knobs will have a different range. So now we are on energy of 1, which means that each knob will have the range of negative positive 1 volt. On energy of 3, we will have negative positive 5 volts. And on energy of 5, we will have positive negative 10 volts. And again, 0 volts in the center. So we can also use Entropia for modulation purposes and not only for controlling pitch. And of course, the energy function is also a CV input, so we can modulate it and change the different ranges with external sources. If we input 0 volts, we will get energy of 3. Positive 1 volt means energy of 5, and negative 1 volts means energy of 1. And again, we can choose different settings for each of the sequences. Now, let's have a look at how the sequences interact with one another. We have for each step a probability knob, which will affect one of two things, or which sequence will go to the output, the blue one or the yellow one, or if on the current step, the two values from both sequences will be added together, and let's see what I mean by that. First of all, let's initialize the sequencer, and then send the main output to the quantizer so we can stay in a certain scale. And from there to Basel from Volt, which is going then to SLAP, also from Volt, which is our VCA and envelope generator. Now let's change the values of the blue sequence, and by using the magnetic clock button, I can move the sequence manually. So we have a sequence setup, and you can see that all the probability knobs are set to blue, which means that only the blue sequence will play. So let's change the values of the yellow sequence, and change also the probability of each step. And now when we play the sequence, you will see that sometimes the blue steps will play and sometimes the yellow ones. So now we have the blue sequence, yellow, 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 blue, and so on. So what we get is one sequence built out of two different sequences. Now we can also choose to add the two sequences together, and we can do that by changing the microstate mode from switch, which will switch between the sequences like we've just seen, to add, which will add the two values together. So now I will change this to add, and we can go step by step. So now two values are added together, just the blue one, and so on. Now we can also modulate the microstate mode and change between switch and add with an external source. And we also have a master probability knob, which will offset the probability values we chose for each step. And this knob can also be modulated with an external source, and the modulation range is negative, positive 5 volts. We also have the invert microstate button and dedicated trigger input, so we can manually invert the microstate mode. So if now both sequences are active, I can invert it, and now just the blue is active, and I can go like this step by step and choose the values for each of the sequences. Now this is in general how this sequencer is working, switching between two different sequences or combining them, all according to the probability settings. Now the cool thing about Entropia is that we can choose the source of each sequence. We can use fixed CV, like a normal sequencer, like we've just seen. We can use external signals, control voltage or audio signals. And we can also use a random source, which will act like a sample and hold for each and every step. And of course, we can also combine different sources, one for the blue sequence and a different one for the yellow sequence. So let's start building a patch utilizing all of those features. Okay, so let's start with the fixed CV mode. Let's change the values of the blue sequence. We'll make it something like this. And the yellow sequence also. Something like this here. Now let's choose to add the two sequences together, not to switch them, but to add the two values together. Let's use also quantum, so we stay in a certain scale. We will say, let's say E flat, G flat and B flat. And for our voice, we will use the wave oscillator from Blamsoft, which is a wavetable oscillator. And let's send the sequencer through quantum to the oscillator, to the volt per octave input of the oscillator. Let's turn on also the cable opacity. Now we have three options for running Entropia with a clock. We can use the certain clock input. Let me just zoom in a bit so we can see this. We have a certain clock input, which will move the sequence normally through each step. We can use the uncertain clock input, which will jump forwards in a randomly fashion. Or we can choose to use both, and this we can do by clicking this button here. So now both are activated. Now just the certain clock is active. Now just the uncertain clock is active, and now again both are active. So let's use a multiplied clock for the certain clock, every clock multiplied by 4, and a divided clock for the uncertain clock or the uncertain input. So every now and then the sequence will jump between steps. Let's send the oscillator to the mixer and see how this sounds like. Very nice. Now we can also change the overall length of the sequence by clicking this button here. Or modulating it. And this will receive voltage from 0 to positive 10 volts. So let's really use a 7-step sequence. And now let's change the probability of step 1 and step 5. So on those steps, there is a chance that the values of both sequences will add up and output a combined value. Now I've changed the values of all steps of the yellow sequence, but only on step 1 and 5 there is a chance that they will add up. So let's trigger the invert microstate function for changing the state of more steps. And for this we will use the Bernoulli gate or branches from Audible Instruments. I have this here. Let's use again the multiplied clock. This here, and change the probability a bit. And send output A to the invert microstate function. So it will invert the microstate randomly. So now we have a sequence which is stable most of the time and repetitive, but with a few surprises here and there, and I think that is exactly what makes this sequencer so unique and fun. Very nice. Now we can also use another sequencer to modulate the oscillator. So let's duplicate what we have here already. Take it here. Okay, let's turn off this time the Planck constant mode. So the values are not quantized and will have a greater range. We will use the same clocks. So the multiplied clock for the certain input and the divided for the uncertain input. Let's also use the Bernoulli gate to trigger the invert microstate function. We'll use the same output. Okay, let's also connect both sequences to the reset of the clock. So they will run nicely together and reset them. Now let's send the output of this sequencer to modulate the position of the wavetable. Let's see. Yeah. We can also add more waves by raising the density. Something like this. Very nice. Okay, so now we have this going. Let's have a look at using external sources with Entropia. So let me just mute this for a second. And let's add another sequencer, another Entropia. I have it here. Change its skin. Now let's change both sequences to external signal by clicking this button here. And for now we will stay with the control voltage. So in this mode, the knobs for each step become attenuverters, so we can attenuate the external signal and even invert it. Another thing to keep in mind is that the energy settings and the Planck constant functions are disabled when in the different modes other than fixed CV. So let's use two different LFOs as our external signals, and for this we will use the tri LFO from AS. Let's send a sine wave to the blue sequence, change its frequency a bit, and a triangle wave to the yellow sequence. Again, change also its frequency, make it a bit more faster, something like this. And let's start changing the values of each step for both sequences. And remember that in this case, each knob acts as an attenuverter, attenuating and inverting the incoming signal. So let's make something like this here. Something for the blue one, for the yellow one also. Very nice. Now this time we will not change the probability for each step, but instead we will modulate the main probability knob, offsetting the probability of both sequences. So we will use the third LFO for this. And we will have to change it to be a bipolar LFO, so it will fit the range of the CV input, negative, positive 5 volts. Let's make it a bit slower. Now let's use again the same clocks. And again, use the reset also of the main clock. And let's have a look at the scope for a second to see how this looks like. So this is the result, what we will get. We can make the triangle wave even a bit faster. Something like this. Interesting modulation source. Very nice, let's get rid of the scope. Now we can use this to modulate the frequency of the wave oscillator. So let's change the first mode in this oscillator to frequency modulation and modulate it using this sequencer. Let me just unmute everything. Let's have a listen. You can see this also here on the scope. Very cool. Okay, so now we can also use audio rate signals. So let's add another sequencer, change its skin again, and change it to external source, but external audio source by clicking this button here. Let's use the same clocks. And again, the reset function also, reset everything. Very nice. Let's set this to a 5-step sequence. Now again, the knobs are in this case attenuverters. So let's change the values of both sequences. We just need 5 steps this time. So let's do something like this. Okay, and as a voice, we will use the palm loop oscillator from 21 kHz. Let's tune it to E flat to meet our scale, to fit our scale. So this is now C, C sharp, D, D sharp, or E flat. We will use a sawtooth wave and we will send it to the blue sequence, to the external signal input of the blue sequence. And a square wave, which is 1 octave lower, to the yellow sequence. Let's change the probability settings for each step, somewhere in the middle maybe. Something like this. Let's have a look again on the scope for a second. See what we get here. So this is the result. We can also choose to add both signals together. So we get something even more interesting. Very nice. Now, let's use also tangents from Volt as our filter. We will send the signal to the low pass input of tangents and from there to the mixer. Let's take the octave one down. Oh yeah, resonance. Very cool. Now, an interesting thing about this mode, the external audio source mode, is that there is a built-in anti-pop function. So there is a small slew or fade between the different steps, so we don't get those clicks and pops in the sound. What we can also do is modulate tangents with the same sequencer that modulates the wavetable of the wave oscillator. So let's send it to the cutoff point of tangents and open the attenuverter a bit. Let's solo this for a second, so we can hear how much movement is in the sound, because the signal is being attenuated and inverted, and it also moves between two different sounds, the sawtooth wave and the square wave. Very nice. Now, let's have a look at the random mode. So let's add another sequencer. I will add it here. Now, let me just mute this for a second. In random mode, Entropia will sample an internal random source that has a range of 0 to positive 5 volts according to the clock it's receiving. So each time it's being triggered by the clock, it will sample this internal signal, just like a sample and hold unit does. And also here, each knob of each step is an attenuverter, so we can dial in the amount and polarity of the random source on each and every step. Now, the fun begins when combining the random mode with a different mode, so we have our stable sequence, but with random changes here and there. So let's use again an external CV signal on the blue sequence. And the yellow sequence will be random. And what we will do, we will use another sequencer, the Turing machine. The Turing machine will send the sequence to the blue sequence of Entropia. And Entropia will add its special seasoning in the shape of a random sequence. Now, I know what you're thinking, the Turing machine is already generating random sequences, but we will lock a sequence and see what happens. So let's send the same clock to the Turing machine and to Entropia. I will use again the multiplied by 4 clock. Let's also reset both of them. Something like this. Now let's look a 5-step sequence on the Turing machine. So I will change the length to 5 and lock a sequence. And we will use a 7-step sequence on Entropia just to make it more interesting, and turn all 7 steps of the blue sequence fully clockwise, all the way to the right, because I want to use all the voltage from the Turing machine, not attenuated. Let's also duplicate our quantum and put it here, and send the signal first to quantum. And for our voice, we will use the cosmic oscillator from animated circuits. Let's activate both oscillators. Let's detune them also slightly by using the sense knobs. Send the signal from quantum to the volt per octave input of the cosmic oscillator. We will also use the VCA from AS, and also the ADSR module, the envelope generator from AS. Let's take the sustain all the way down, attack also a bit down. We will send both oscillator 1 and oscillator 2 to the VCA, and the ADSR will modulate their level, or will modulate the VCA, and will receive a gate from quantum. And let's see how this sounds like. I will unmute everything and send this to the mixer. Very nice. Now let's change the values of a few steps of the yellow sequence. So the first one maybe, just a bit. Remember, this is attenuating the random voltage or the random signal. So the first one, the third, the fifth, and the seventh. Very nice. And change also the probability for those steps. Something like this. Let's mute everything other than this sequence so we can listen to it. So we got a steady sequence from the Turing machine, but on a few steps we get also another random sequence, changing the main sequence slightly, making it more interesting. Very cool. Now let's use the same signal coming out of the Turing machine to modulate the phase distortion of the first oscillator. So we will do something like this, and let's open the attenuator a bit. And let's use the signal coming out of the volts extension to modulate the phase distortion of the second oscillator. Let's change the values a bit. Let's lock also a different sequence here. Yeah. Very nice. Now we can use this signal also to modulate the decay time of the ADSR module. So there is even more motion in the sound. Let's also use the Bernoulli gate again to change the macro state mode. We'll use a different output. So now the signal from the Turing machine and the random signal will sometimes switch, and sometimes will be added together. Take the octave down maybe here. Very nice. So we have a nice sequence full of movement, but still has its own repetitive style to it. And again, that's the beauty, I think, of Entropia, this game between the microstate, each step with its own values, and the macrostate, the overall sequence. A few more things I want to show you. Let me just zoom in a bit. We can stop and run the sequence by using this button here. and also trigger it with an external source. And we can also activate the reset on run mode, which will reset the sequencer each time the run function is being activated. And of course, like we've seen before, we can choose between two different skins. Like all of the Geodesics collection, we have the white light edition or the dark matter edition. Very cool. And that's it, guys. Like always, there will be a link in the description to this patch so you can download it and have a closer look. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please hit the like button. If you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe and hit the bell. And have a good one.